Well done, Graham. Man, that looked tough. I could see you gave it your all. You had a bit of a speed wobble here and there, you know. Yeah, but you know what? Well done. Proud of you, man. But of course, with an exercise routine that hectic, you need to make sure that you eat healthy as well. And that is what we're going to be doing this morning. We have a great alternative healthy recipe for you this morning using quinoa, Mr. Michael. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Great stuff. Yeah. So quinoa is a recipe that not a lot of people are familiar with.
And yeah, it's not a very common thing. Quite new to us here, really. It's a sacred Inca crop, and it was domesticated about 3,000-4,000 years ago.
All right.
Grown in the Andean region, the Andes, that ridge of mountains that runs down the length of South America. It's not a grain, it's actually a seed of a plant that's related to beetroot and spinach. And it's also related to a plant called goosefoot and fat hen. And there's tumbleweeds. You know the tumbleweeds?
Yes.
Also part of the same,
thing.
They're packed with amino acids. It's what they call a dicotyledonous seed, so there are two parts to it.
Okay.
Packed with amino acids. It's a complete protein within itself, which is great news for vegetarians.
Yes.
And then has the sort of the iron and fiber and calcium and phosphorus and all these wonderful things. Easy to cook as well. You cook it much the same way as rice. And for the salad, which we're going to do just now, you toast the quinoa first in a dry in a saucepan, and then you just pop water over, salt it, and there you go.
All right, and that's so what it looks like. Cooked version.
That's what it looks like when it's cooked.
All right, and how long does it take you to get from this to this?
Sort of about 15 minutes or so.
All right.
It's gluten-free as well, so it's good for people.
Can it get any better?
Yeah, absolutely.
what are we making a salad this morning, but how can you use it in day-to-day
You can
day
use
recipes?
It much the same way as you use rice or couscous.
So it could be a good substitute.
Yeah, absolutely.
Perfect. All right, so we are going to be making a quinoa salad after the break. You don't want to miss that. Very, very healthy, especially for, as Michael said, vegetarians or even for those guys that we've just saw, you know, need those proteins to build those muscles. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
We found goodness in goed gedacht olive oil and all the good they do for the community. Pick and Pay.
Welkom terug, jy is ingeskakel by jou goed voel aan bytprogram net hier op SABC3. And just before the break, Mr. Michael Olivet told us about the fantastic health properties of quinoa, which is a great alternative to either rice or couscous. And right now, we're going to be making a lovely quinoa salad, Mr. Michael.
Absolutely.
All right, so I've been stirring my little toasting.
Yes.
The level quinoa seeds in there, as you can see, it's getting nice and brown now.
Absolutely.
So this is obviously the first step.
That's the first step.
Okay.
But when we were talking earlier, I should have mentioned that you can get quinoa in different colors as well. So brown, red, black. But this is the one that's really most available.
All right.
So what we do now is you cook it exactly the same way as rice. You just put some water over.
All right.
Turn the temperature down and then just...
What is the relation between water and the actual quinoa seeds?
It's usually like sort of one quinoa to two water.
Yeah. Okay.
So we just put some salt in there as well.
Lovely.
And then that just simply cooks away and lands up looking like that.
Okay, so that's... Okay, perfect.
Yeah. So now what I'm going to do is we're going to make a salad.
All right.
Here we've got some sweet potato. Which we've roasted with onion and chili and salt and pepper.
Perfect.
And then obviously chilled it down.
Oh, that looks lovely.
Now I'm going to make salad dressing.
All right, so let me turn this
down. We're going to start off with some apple cider vinegar.
Okay.
And to that, I'm going to add just a teaspoon of Dijon mustard.
Mm-hmm.
I really like putting mustard in at this stage.
I've made a couple of salad dressing with you before and yours are absolutely
Because
perfect.
What happens is it creates a nice emulsion and it sort of thickens up the dressing.
Yes.
Now what I'm going to do is, this is sunflower oil.
Okay.
And I'm going to add an equal amount of olive oil to it. I like olive oil hugely in salads.
Yes.
But I just find that sometimes it's a little bit overwhelming.
I see.
So you can use either sunflower oil or grapeseed oil is very nice.
That's also good. That's all healthy oils.
Absolutely.
Perfect.
So here we go.
All right. So you can, of course, get all the ingredients sent to your phone. You can just SMS the keyword salad to 33728. We'll send you on the Pick and Pay shopping list.
Absolutely.
Cool.
So there we go. And you see it's thickened up quite nicely.
Mm-hmm.
Now, one little secret which I use. People often say to me, oh, your salad dressings taste so stunning. What special do you put in? Soy sauce.
Really?
Yeah, and you know that it just makes such a difference. Just a little splash.
It's your regular soy sauce.
Yeah, absolutely.
Hmm.
And then I also like just to put a little
honey.
A little
in there.
Drizzle of honey, and just to give it a
that's
little.
That's the one thing I know. You know,
just
you
to give
love
it a little
honey
sweet,
there.
Sweet edge. You can also use agave nectar, or you can just put a bit of sugar into it if you haven't.
But honey, a great alternative.
Honey's
right.
Tremendous. So there we are. We've got our dressing.
A little bit of salt.
Some salt and pepper in.
Right.
And I just love the way it sort of thickens up like this.
Yeah.
And what I do is I usually make a lot more than I need. Then I put it in a jar in the fridge, and then you just shake it up before you need to use it again.
And I can see this really being a lovely lunchtime snack on a hot summer day.
Absolutely. Right, so here we go.
Right.
And we put in some lettuce. If you can get some lettuce with some red stuff in it, just sort of makes it that much more amusing. Pretty to look at.
Pretty to look at.
And then we'll pop in the sweet potato. Mm. And here I've got some Granny Smith apple.
All right.
Nice to use Granny Smith because it's quite tart. So there we've got the apple. And then we've got some that lovely thinly sliced
red onion,
which is really makes a lovely
salad. Coming together very, very nice.
And here we add the
That's it. The
quinoa.
And this is quite, I mean, even though this is a salad, I think because of the quinoa, it could be quite filling as well.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a perfect, complete wonderful meal.
Oh, look at that. Just once again, the keyword, if you would like to have all the ingredients sent to your phone, is salad to 33728. We'll send you on the Pick n Pay shopping list.
Right, so there we go. So there's our salad. Now what we'll do is we'll just...
It's very easy, actually. Just a little bit of pre-prep and then we're done.
Absolutely. The pre-prep is the most important.
Yes.
What the chef's called mise en place, everything in its place.
Ah, mise en place, yeah.
And there you go. It's such a lovely salad. And then what we'll do is we'll just garnish it with some toasted pine nuts.
Oh.
Just adding it that lovely
salad
flavor.
Fit for a king, indeed.
Absolutely. And then some chopped parsley. And there we are.
Only you can make a salad look that good. Michael, wow. Thank you so much.
Pleasure.
Of course, SMS the keyword salad to 33728. We'll send you on the shopping list. You can make this at home. Brilliant alternative using quinoa rather than rice or even couscous.
Yeah.
Yes. Mr. Michael, thank you so much.
Pleasure.
I'm going to definitely give a taste
Tuck
of this.
In, are you?
And I know the rest of the guys, Graham, Leanne, you have to check out this salad, guys. This seems amazing.
By partnering with the WWF, we found goodness in sustainable fishing practices. Pick n Pay, always there for you.